I'm going to ask you very politely, calmly, and nicely to get out of bed!
So we're at Howe Hill tonight, just flicking the lure around a little bit. Just got a spare couple of hours while I'm waiting some stuff to draw at work. So I thought I'd come out and flick the lures around for a little while that's happening, and I'll go back and carry on. So fingers crossed we might be able to find a fish. It's a lovely evening, as you can see. So what I'm doing is I'm working in a sort of fan motion from right to left, and just trying to see if I can pick up a few fish in the area, or just a bite would be nice to start with, and we can work out from there. I'm quite happy just to get the one fish, but obviously multiple would be nice. Yeah. sort of done around the whole area. I could carry on and do it all again, or I could move on. I think today I'm just going to move on, just keep moving swims till we find a bite and work our way along the river. This way, I think. Well, I could have stayed there, don't get me wrong, I could have switched up all different lures and, you know, give that a good hour there if I wanted to, but I don't really see it being much point. That looks a nice spot, but down there it says electric eel boat, strictly no fishing, so can't fish on there. What have we got here then? Oh, we've got like a little boat shed inlety bit. I always like these sort of bits for the food casts, so we're definitely going to have a cast here. I would expect the pike to be laying in here when the flow's rough in the weather. Even though it's not at the moment. We've got another inlet or outlet over there as well. So it could be a good area. Everyone's got a couple of nice boats around here as well. Same lure. I'm going to keep on this lure because it's a proven lure to me. Caught fish out of the boards on it quite a lot, including yesterday. And cast right across into that area over there. Let it sink down a bit. Pull it across. A great sort of ambush area for him to be sitting. I'm also looking for like rudd and roach and stuff surfacing and stuff like that. If you start seeing them, then you know the pike won't be too far behind them. Look around the area, trying different spots. A little bit of a pledge moving out there in the middle. That's quite a fast current going to the left out there. Thank you. this evening. Which is lovely compared to what we've had lately, 30, 40, 50 mile an hour wind. For about 2 weeks. Up to some inner doors. Goes in there. Looks like it's a bit weedy in there. Get into that bay with this size lure on. That entrance would be definitely a good spot. No takes yet, not enough little jacks or anything. This car's down river there. That's probably going to be it for that spot. Normally if there's a few pike in the area, you normally find them fairly quickly. Sometimes that can take an hour or so, but let's move on down here now, shall we? We'll just keep going until we hopefully hook up. Get your bag on. going past. Someone's had a bit of a fight through the bushes here to try and fish there. We need proper areas really, and can safely land the fish and stuff. So we got over to the right in the field. Old windmill water pump type thing here. Looks like they've been down here cutting down trees and clearing the area. It's always good. Broadman's Mill. Something a bit different than what the skeleton's all about. I suppose if you fall off the top of there, you probably what it means. Little gap behind the bushes. We'll attempt it. You never know. You never know. Plus in the evening when it's like this sort of time of night, there's not many people about, so it's not leaving me blocking the path or anything. Still cover straight left and right. Oh, we had a take in. Damn. Oh. Right close down on the bushes down the side there. There we go again. That time. Oh, that's a shame, isn't it? Probably scared to swim now, though. Can hear another boat coming. Right, let's keep moving. Making the most of the daylight we got. Fish as many swims as we can. Give ourselves as much chance as possible to find a fish. A boat going down river. Obviously just through the bushes there. Absolutely crawling down the river. Near fishing by looks like. A little gap there, but a bit of a pain to cast around. Right. Evening, how you doing?
Alright. Plenty of roach anyway.
Getting lots of roach, yeah?
Yeah, but a few good.
Oh, nice.
A couple of perch in. I had one gudgeon.
Oh, right, yeah.
It's quite nice, really, getting that. What are you after?
I'm trying to get a pike tonight.
Oh, yeah.
I normally do what you're doing, but I'm normally on the feeder. But I thought I'd just change it up tonight, because I've only got a couple of hours in between work.
That's my first snag today. So, do you get many pike?
Sometimes.
Yeah.
Just talking to a nice chap down there, fishing on the pole. And he's literally getting a fish a chuck. He's getting medium-sized roach. Anything up to sort of half a pound. He's had some gudgeon, bits and pieces as well. Fishing maggot and caster and stuff like that. So I advised him to get onto some bigger baits. See if he can get some bigger roach and some bigger bream. Right, so we're looking for our next swim. I'd say his swim was absolutely full of roach as soon as he cast in and trickled through. Bite, bite, bite. I would have thought there'd been some pike there, to be honest, but he said there hadn't been nothing splashing around or anything. It's looking nice down here. I hope there's a... Oh, yeah. Just what I wanted. Nice swim right there, look. I've never been down here before, by the way, so I'm finding out for myself what's here as well. Not sure what this is here. We'll have a quick look and see what that is. Some sort of mill type wheel. It's different. Right, let me show you what I just found, because there's a nice swim here. You've got all that river down there. All out in front of us, and all that river to the left. Can't be too bad, can it? Alright, let's put the gear down. Let's have a few casts. Fingers crossed. We might hook up to something then. Absolutely lovely swim. You're gonna have to come here with the feeder. That's what I like about wandering about, I guess, doing a bit of lure fishing. You find new swims for other stuff as well. Never found myself a new swim. So I'm going to run the float through, put the feeder out in the middle. There's a few small fish coming to the surface and topping. Down river. Just looking out for any pike strikes or any fish coming to the surface. Being chased by pike and stuff. Perch. Come on, fishies. I'm thinking I slacked them like this. Because the flow's more going down the far side. It's in the slack, you'd think it'd be an ideal spot for a take. starting to get dark on me. This is the perfect time to get a bite now. Getting no weed or nothing, which is good. I've had a lot of that lately when I've been out, which I don't want. All the fish just got scared in front of me, which means there was a pike following my lure in, I reckon. They all come flying up to the surface, as you probably saw. Pike down there, it's disturbing all the fish. The person who wants to take the lure is a different thing. Come on, Mr. Pike. Come on.
Where are you? Ooh, not in the bushes. Don't want to do that.
Last thing we need to do. Taken if I stole down there. Come on, fishies, come on. So we'll go one more swim this way. Oh, look at that white owl. Lovely pure white owl. Nice. Yeah, we're running out of light quite quickly, so I'll go down to the next swim, wherever that may be. Just reading the sign, make sure it's not private, it's not. Ooh, can we get another swim? That's the thing. I think it's walking away from the river a little bit. We don't want to do that. That swim definitely looked nice for some feeder fishing or run the float through. That's for sure. We'll come and do that fairly soon, I think. Then. Come on, we need some more swims before it gets dark. Another big bird there, I think it was a heron. Didn't quite see it properly. And there's that white owl again. There's obviously some nice wildlife around there. Get us back on the river. Well, it's just going on for miles and miles in the undergrowth, and I can't get anywhere near the river. The only way I can get down in the river is by my boat, so it's going to be all this unfished river all the way along there. But I can't get to it tonight because that'll be dark before I get anywhere. So I'm going to go back to the room where I started and see what light we got left by the time we walk back there. Well, we're back down this end where that lovely swim was. Sun's going down in the distance. It's getting dark. Hopefully we'll get down here a little bit and have a few more casts. So we're at the swim where that chap was fishing. It's getting too dark to film now, that's the trouble. On this one that I've got at the moment. That's not very good at low light. What I'll do is I'll have a few more casts, and if I get anything, hopefully I'll be able to show you. So I didn't manage anything there. No walking back to where I started. Never go in that bay again. And then I'm going to be walking back to the car. So not very productive. We had one take, didn't we? Down this end. Otherwise, very quiet. It was only a few weeks ago there was a big old salt surge down here though, so don't know how many pike are going to be down here, but there's plenty of smaller fish down here. Rod and roach and that sort of thing. So you would think that the pike would have followed them up here. Come back to the windmill bit now. Look in the distance, you can see the lights, all the boats and stuff.